Hi, I'm Pete Murray, and you are on Speaker TV. It's been far. Yeah, Charlie, my eldest one, he was, he was probably about 3 when he first started to, even 2 maybe, come to some of the shows. So he kind of grew up with it. And I remember doing a show in London where he was up late. I was finished, I did the encore, and the crowd was going, you know, really wild. And then they just sort of stepped up another level, and it was just going crazy. I'm thinking, oh, wow, it must have been a pretty good song. Love. Just thinking, what, you know. Next minute, I felt these two arms around my leg, and this, you know, little Charlie was only about this high, sort of came out and wrapped his arms around my legs, and the crowd just went nuts, you know. It's great. Please take me right in. Because everyone has been a moment in time. You're like a poem that's caught in my head. I curse the day when I see. Oh, you know, it's just luck for me. I remember being, I was 22, and I was, my flatmate at the time, he just happened to come into my room, and by chance he said, mate, you know, like, I'm going to get some guitar lessons. Going to learn the guitar. I've always wanted to do it, and so I'm going to finally go and do it. And I kind of thought, yeah, it sounds like a pretty good idea, so I actually went and had a couple of lessons, and he didn't. Remember being in a two-bedroom apartment. This is in London with 19 other Aussies living in the place. 19. Yeah, it was pretty full on. And there was myself and Angus McDonald from Sneaky Sound System. Angus had always been playing his original stuff for years. So we were sitting in the lounge room one night, and he'd play an original, I'd play a cover, and he'd play an original, I'd play a cover. And one of the girls there said, you know, why don't you play us one of your songs? And I was like, oh, no, I don't write songs. And she said, why not? I was like, okay, I don't know, I don't do it. And she said, well, you should. That's the first time I actually thought about, you know, songwriting. I never also let age really worry me, you know. I was kind of always just did what I wanted to do, and I was right into sport when I was younger, and I never really did things for money. It was kind of always about lifestyle, and what I, you know, like, sport was what I wanted to do, so that's what I went out and did. I was studying natural medicine at the time, so I thought when I finished my sporting career, then I'd maybe, you know, have a degree, and I could go and have my own clinic, start working with sporting teams and athletes, and that's where I thought I'd end up. But then music came along, and everything's kind of changed. Blue sky blue, come on, close those eyes and realize what your dreams want you to do. If the dream is gone, it ain't all wrong, you gotta drag yourself on through. Hi, this is Pete Murray, and this is my Mog playlist. One of the first songs that I really, I guess, got me going was around the time when I was just starting to play guitar, and I got into Neil Young. Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere. It was the album, and it's the song also off that album. I couldn't stop playing this song, but I'd kind of got into Neil earlier, when I was probably about 19, I was probably about 23 at this stage. I'd never heard of this album before. It just happened to be sitting as an old record, actually, at this guy's house in Canada where I was working for a while. And I thought, I'll chuck this on, have a listen to it. And that track was just this really simple track, but it was so cool. The Doors, Hyacinth House, off LA Woman. I loved it so much, I actually did a recording of it. And put it out just a couple of years ago on a little EP. To you now.
You say love's gonna send me. Speaker TV.